Well, the second hour of the day is the Immaculate Conception for me, which sounds like an unlikely kind of name for this, but I chose it because of the meaning of Immaculate Conception in the most symbolic and metaphoric way, not dogmatic at all. When you think about the Immaculate Conception, you're really talking about something unblemished and pure. And all of the mystics of the church spoke of a place in the soul they called the divine spark. In French, it's the virgin point. It's that place in the soul that is purely God, the divine, untouched by anything else. It's the Immaculate Conception in all of us. So it is our deepest connection to the divine. So that hour of the day is to acknowledge that and to connect with that, to tap in again to this place in our own soul that is the deepest and purest thing, the divine spark. And I do that in several ways. I may sit and meditate with one of my icons. I may pray, I may read, I may journal, but most of the time, and my favorite thing is to go out to my dock and sit by the water and watch the tides and the birds. The best way to pray for me is to sit and be and not try so hard.